Yo, yo, Baraka. Yo, yo, Baraka. The gang on the loose, nothing you could do. The beast on the move, bully coming through. Trigger, tracer, drifter coming through. Add the snake that makes Baraka crew. Yo, yo, Baraka. The gang on the loose, nothing you could do. You can try, but why? You know you're gonna lose. Yo, yo, Baraka. Yo, yo, Baraka. The beast on the move, bully coming through. Trigger, tracer, drifter coming through. Add the snake that makes Baraka crew. Yo, yo, Baraka.
Hey, what's up? I have a treat for you guys. The Baraka. Now these are Bionicle sets. Now to the Transformers fans of this channel, what's a Bionicle? Well, if you never heard of Bionicle, they're a line of Lego sets that were released back in late 2000 to early 2001-ish in England. But that's not relevant right now, because these guys were released in 2005 and were the main villains of that year of sets. Because the first wave in the first half of the year was the villains, and in the second wave the second half of the year was the heroes. And boy are these guys villains. They're like gangsters and mercenaries. They used to work for a group called the Dark Hunters, but eventually left to search for the Mask of Life, where they meet our heroes and completely kick their asses. Then a new group of heroes shows up and tries to take them down, and there's a whole adventure, ends up underwater, and they get mutated. It's the whole thing. I don't want to chew up too much time talking about the story, so now the sets. So a bit of explaining on the sets. They are the start of a new way of building the Generation 1 Bionicle sets, ultimately known as the Anika / Baraka build. The sets previous to these had geared mechanisms and poor articulation, so they had cool functions, but you couldn't really pose them very well, especially in the arms, except for in the case of Pohatsu, you couldn't really pose his legs. These got rid of the gears and implemented blasters and introduced amazing articulation into Bionicle sets. Now, onto the toys themselves. They are clone sets, meaning that they're almost identical minus a few details such as the head sculpt, colors, feet, all that sort of stuff. My favorite one here is Avak. Not only because he's brown, like me, but also because I just like the way his face is designed. It just looks neat to me. Fun fact, this was also the last major set to be released in brown. Apparently, brown doesn't sell well. Gee, thanks. They decided to use yellow and orange for the stone characters after that, immediately after that, like the second wave of Bionicle sets from 2006, the stone Toa was yellow and gray and orange and stuff. Anyways, the main details of the sets that differentiate them from other Bionicle sets include the spines, the teeth, the lopsided arms, and the large webbed and clawed feet. The webbed feet are my favorite.
Yeah, to be fair though, I'm not a big feet guy.
Because they're very large and they keep the set stable and planted on the ground, whereas the clawed ones are a little too short in the heels, so they like to fall over sometimes. They also have different weapons to articulate the elements that they coincide with. For example, Avak here, the stone Baraka, has a jackhammer and a pickaxe, which is really, really cool. And he's also the only one to have the weapon arm fitted backwards, because the claw on the jackhammer side has to fit somewhere, so that's pretty cool. The next set I want to take a look at is Zaktan, and this is a good time to talk about my show, Bionicle Journey to Home. Here's a sneak peek of Zaktan's shenanigans in the show.
Go! Get him!
Should we help him?
Nah. Stop him! Don't let him advance!
Zaktan here is the leader of the group and is the most intimidating looking Baraka. His face just like screams, grr. That was stupid. He has the cool three-bladed scissor weapon, which is my favorite weapon of the bunch. I just wish you could articulate the scissors. Because if they had, like, engineered a way to clip the scissor blades onto the actual weapon itself, that would have been nicer, but that might just be me asking for a little too much. The green and gold is a really cool combo, too, that we don't see very often in Bionicle, which makes the set a little bit more unique, and I love it. Plus, this was my only Paraka for about 14 years. This is not my original one, though. My original one is completely, like, cracked and broken. This is a brand new one I had to buy. But, yeah, this was my first Paraka set. Next up is Thok, whose name sounds a lot like he's the white Paraka, and according to the ad, yes, that ad, he's the lazy guy. Don't worry, we will talk about that ad in a little bit. And he's really cool, because he's got this really cool ice blaster, and he's the only Paraka where you can actually see all of the teeth, like none of his teeth are covered up. The teeth, by the way, glow in the dark, and the eyes light up too, and why will I wait until just now to mention that? Well, Thok is the only set I have where the eyes still work. The batteries die very quickly, and you can't really change them without damaging the eye stalk, because you gotta like pry it open with a screwdriver and stuff, and you can chip it. It's a whole thing. It's not fun to do anyways. Moving on. Phazok, the blue one, has the cool harpoon weapon that fits very well with the water theme. I believe this was also the first main character from Bionicle that was blue that wasn't a female. Correct me if I'm wrong on that, but yeah, this guy's a dude. And he's also the first one we're going to take a look at with clawed feet. But Phazok has a really interesting story clip. So the Paraka broke into the lair of the big bad guy of the entire Bionicle story, Makuta Pterodax. Hakan, a Paraka we'll look at in just a second, was playing with it and hit Phazok and split Phazok into two beings, Phazok and Phazon. Phazon, I will review at some point. I have already reviewed it once, but I don't like that video, so I'm going to redo it. Hakan looks like the bully, hence, you know, that ad. But to me, he's not very interesting. I mean, the weapon is kind of bland and boring. And he was the poster child for a lot of Bionicle, for a lot of Bionicle's Paraka wave. Him and Phazok were the poster childs, but Hakan was shoved in your face a lot more, and that kind of oversaturated his design for me. But I mean, for the most part, he's fine, but yeah, he's my least favorite of the bunch. And finally, we have Radak, the main character in my show, so please check it out again, links in the description, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the miniseries that comes out. He's got the cool goggles and the big-ass crimson chin on his face. I mean, where else would there be a chin? And the cool mining tool for a weapon, it's got a drill and a spinny thing. And Radak isn't an idiot in the actual story lore. He's an idiot in my story, but in the lore, he's kind of like an inventor, sort of. I mean, that's more Avak's thing, but he also kind of did that a little bit on the side. But yeah, in my show, he's a bit of an idiot, but there's more. It's going to be more complex than just being an idiot, so make sure you check it out. Again, links in the description. Overall, these guys look pretty sick together, and compared to other sets and a couple of Transformers, they're very large, especially next to like Voyager Megatron here. You can pick these guys up for just a few bucks on Bricklink, so I'll link Bricklink in the description, not sponsored, so you can check that out if you want to order them for yourself. If you're a Bionicle fan and you don't own these, buy them. What are you doing with your life? Every Bionicle fan needs at least one Paraka. That's just, yeah, Paraka. Articulation wise, they have all the same joints, so I'm just going to show Avak here, but they all have their, like, every joint is a ball joint, so you can basically do almost anything you'd want it to do. So there's no real point about talking about bicep swivels and elbow joints, because they all do the same thing. I guess the elbows are a bit different in the way that they're done, just because the pieces they used were very different, because they wanted to get that lopsided asymmetric effect. But other than that, they're pretty much, you pose them however you want, except for the lack of a waist swivel. Now on to the ad. What does it mean when I talk about the ad? Well, the famous Paraka rap. The ad Lego thought was a good idea, but is now just a huge meme. I'll link it down below so you can take a look at it and get a taste of the cringe that is the Paraka rap. But the ad's animation is actually very good. It holds up almost perfectly to today's standards. But why a rap song? Yo, Paraka. Yo, Paraka.
The gang on the loose, nothing you could do. The beast on the move, bully coming through. Trigger, tracer, drifter coming through. Add the snake that makes Piraka crew. Yo, yo, Piraka. The gang on the loose, nothing you could do, you can try, but anyways, the Piraka, if you're a Bionicle fan, you should get at least one of these sets, if not all of them. Like I said, they're pretty cheap. I think the most expensive one here was Avac. He was about $14, I think. And I bought these all used. It's about $14. And the cheapest one, funny enough, was Zactan. Zactan was $3.50. So you can pick these guys up for dirt cheap. It's really, really good. And if you don't own a Bionicle set, maybe don't start with these ones. You probably want to start with like a Toa Mata or a Toa Nuva or a Bulrock or something like that. But then go into these, because these are not traditional Bionicle. They don't have masks. They don't have elemental powers and all that sort of stuff. They're just there. They have spines. They're a creature known as Skakti. This group is called Piraka. Let's just get that straight. But yeah, I'd start with even the Toa Anika, I'd start with over these guys. But these guys are really, really good. They're very unique, and to my knowledge, anyways, the only time LEGO's ever made anything close to gangsters and like gangs and violence, and they literally go to an island and shoot everyone there. That's like, and we're not allowed to get the LEGO Osprey. Yeah. Anyways, that has been my look at the LEGO Bionicle Piraka. I definitely recommend buying these if you're a Bionicle fan. If you want to get into Bionicle, maybe buy the second or third. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter and Instagram, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.